Why?
Sir, he takes it a little rough.
Can you stop just like, for a moment?
What?
Can you stop?
I gotta back up a little bit.
How'd you like facing that charge?
She's lovely. She's grown so much since I was at Camp David. She had not long arrived, had she?
No, she was
not
very young.
Not long arrived. Oh! For a moment. She's beautiful. And her coat's beautifully soft. Absolutely.
Lunch in the residence, President Reagan, Prime Minister Thatcher.
It's always a pleasure to exchange views with Prime Minister Thatcher, a dear friend and the respected leader of one of America's closest allies. We've had a cordial discussion on a wide range of matters. Our conversations reflected the excellent relationship which exists between our two countries, as well as the warm friendship between Mrs. Thatcher and myself. We discussed East-West relations, and in particular the preparations for the upcoming Geneva talks with the Soviets. We fully agree that the unity, patience, and determination of the North Atlantic Alliance are essential if arms control negotiations are to succeed. What we're seeking are significant reductions in the numbers of nuclear weapons through fair and verifiable agreements. Prime Minister Thatcher and I agree that it's absolutely necessary to continue NATO's INF deployments on schedule in accord with the Alliance's 1979 decision. We're both hopeful that the dialogue opening in Geneva will result in progress. And while that progress continues, however, we will be steadfast in the modernization of our forces and in our determination to promote full adherence to existing arms control agreements. These are crucial incentives to any real progress. Prime Minister Thatcher and I also discussed the current situation in the Middle East and agreed on the need for parties in that region to take concrete steps toward peace. We reviewed the of my close collaboration with my friend, Margaret Thatcher.
Thank you very much. Mr. President, may I say how very grateful I am to you for inviting me for this brief visit, the first official one in your second term, although I paid an unofficial working visit to Camp David in December. Our talks are always particularly valuable because we see so many things in the same way, and you can speak of a real meeting of minds. As the President pointed out, this meeting is a special one because 1985 marks the 200th anniversary of diplomatic relations between Britain and the United States. And I think I can safely say that our relations now are better than when John Adams presented his credentials to King George III. Indeed, I feel no inhibitions about describing the relations as very, very special. and it is a particular honor that President Reagan and Mrs. Reagan have accepted an invitation to dinner at the British Embassy tonight to mark this very special diplomatic anniversary. The President has given you an account of the discussions we had today. We had some very thorough ones, especially about the prospects for arms control negotiations. Those negotiations carry our hopes with them. They will, as I indicated this morning, be complex, but those who are negotiating on part of the West know of our fundamental, sincere wish to get down the number of nuclear weapons in the world in a way which is still balanced and which still keeps our security. We believe our negotiators will strive to that end, and they will carry our good wishes with them. We also spent some time discussing the Middle East, and both agreed that the moment is propitious for a fresh effort to achieve progress towards a Middle Eastern settlement. And I told the President